It's now time to import our spatial data. I shall provide datasets for boundaries and hospitals that you shall use. They will be available in the project repo under the data folder in each of the apps. Kindly note that the boundaries and hospitals data should only be used for learning. I added random bed counts to the hospital data, and thus they are not the true depiction of the current bed capacities in hospitals in Rwanda. With that out of the way, we can now create our hospitals and boundaries apps and their respective models based on the data. Since we did not create a makefile task for the Django startup command, we shall just type it out in the command line. So back to your command line, you can just type docker compose execute on the API service python 3 manage.py startup, call this hospitals. So before you run this command, please make sure that you've built your containers and they're up and running. Then let's also do a startup command for the boundaries. So boundaries. Perfect. We can now add our apps to our settings.py file. So back to your IDE, the settings.py file, let's come to the project apps. So we can say we're going to add hospitals.apps.hospitals config. So the way I'm getting this, just come to the hospitals app, then go to apps, then this is the name. Then the same for boundaries, so boundaries.apps.boundaries config. Let's just copy that. Boundaries is going to be boundaries.apps.boundaries config, like that. Let's confirm boundaries.apps.boundaries config. Perfect. So in each app, we shall have a data directory, which will house the respective shapefiles for the hospitals and the boundaries. So I've already added the data folder in boundaries up here that has the data in terms of the shapefiles. Then also in the hospitals up here, there's the data folder that has this. All this will be available in the project repo on GitHub. To inspect this data locally, you need to install GDAL in your machine. Kindly note that for Windows users, GDAL installation can be a pain. Luckily for us, with our containers, we already configured GDAL and its dependencies. So, if you have GDAL installed locally on your machine, we can use the GDAL OGR info utility to examine the metadata of the shapefiles or other vector data sources. So back in a terminal, in a project root directory, we can run, let's just clear the terminal, we can run OGR info on the hospitals app, on the data folder, it's hospitals.shapefile. So this basically gives us a summary, tells us we have one layer, it's for hospitals, and it's point data. To find out more information, we'll specify a layer name and also use the -so option to get only the important summary information. So we can go back to our terminal and say OGR info. Now we pass in the SO flag, then say on hospitals data, hospitals.shapefile. Then let's give our layer a name, call this hospitals, like that. So if you run this, you'll get summary information of our shapefile. So the layer name is hospitals, yes. Geometry, it's points. Currently there are 49 features or 49 hospitals in our shapefile. Then the coordinate reference system information is also given there. Then at the bottom, we get a summary of the fields that this data contains. So it contains a hospital field. I'm assuming this is the hospital name. Then latitude, longitude, FID, number of beds, then the admin boundaries where these hospitals lie, and the admin boundaries P code. So if you want to see a more detailed list of features and layers, so we can always come back and say OGR info dash, this time passing the AL flag on the hospitals data, hospitals.shapefile, then give the layer a name again. This time we get details of our shapefile. So apart from the other features you'd seen before in terms of the layer name, feature count, the coordinate reference system, remember before we got the summary of the hospitals, lat, long, blah, 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 like this. So if you want to see the details, let's say, what is hospital? Here we just said hospital is a string, but from this you can see hospital is a string and this seems to be the hospital name. Gahini District Hospital. Then the latitude and the longitude values, FID values, the number of beds. If you didn't know what admin E1 means, you see this is Eastern Province. So this shows that this is the boundary name, then the boundary P code. So the AL flag basically gives us like details of all our fields, so we know exactly what to put in our models. So in the hospital's models.py file, we shall create a hospital model based on the hospital fields we had inspected earlier with the OGR info command. So in the hospital's models.py file, let's add some imports. You can say from django.contrib.js.db import models. Then we can say from django.utils.translation import, we say get text lazy as underscore. Then we can have a class of hospital. It's going to subclass models.model. Then we can declare our field. So the first field we're going to declare is the name field. Name is going to be models.character field. And you can see this is going to be the hospital name. And then it's going to have a maximum length of 100. So remember, we are basing these fields based on what we had inspected before with the OGR all command, this. So back, apart from the name field, we can specify longitude. So long is going to be models.character field, and the translated text is going to be longitude is going to be a float field, because if you come here, you say latitude and longitude are real, these are floats. So this is going to be a float field like that. The same applies to latitude. So latitude is models.float field, that is going to be latitude. Perfect. Then the next field is FID. So you can say FID, the field ID is going to be models dot. That's an integer field. Let's just confirm. Yes, it's integer. Perfect. And integer field, this is going to be field ID, like that. Then the next field is going to be the beds. So the beds is going to be models dot, it's an integer field. So we're going to say this is going to be bed numbers. Let's just confirm. Yeah, beds are integers, so we can have a default value. Each hospital at least must have a bed. So we can say default is going to be 1. Then the next one is going to be the province name. So you can name this field whatever we want, because here it's admin1en. We'll layer map this later. You'll see that shortly. So you can say this is the province name. So the province name is models.character field. The representation is going to be province. The translated text to be translated is going to be province. The maximum length of that is, let's make that 100. Then the next field is going to be the province code. That's the P code. So we can say province underscore code is models dot character field, and text to be translated is going to be province code. Province code with a maximum length of not 100, but a maximum length of 1. Then lastly, we're going to specify a geometry field. So if you come here, a geometry field, this is a point field, right? So we can say our geometry field, abbreviated as geom, we can say is models dot point field, and the spatial reference system identity SRID is going to be 4326, like that. So this is a Django specific geometry field with a spatial reference system identity. Then we're going to declare string representation of our model. So you can say define underscore string, like that. We're going to return the name, so you can yourself dot name for that. And that basically marks the end of creating our model. So let's just confirm, yes, hospital, latitude, longitude, FID, beds, admin. Perfect. Then we can now run the make migrations and the migrate commands. So back in our terminal, let's clear that. Then we can say make migrate. Nice. Then we can now create our migrations. You can say make migrations. Then migrate them. Perfect. So to install the hospital data to our database, we shall use the layer mapping Python utility. So back in our IDE, let's in the hospital's application, let's create a new file, and this file is going to be called load.py file. So let's add some code here. So we're going to import the path. So you can say from pathlib import path, then from django.contrib.js.utils, we're going to import layer mapping like that. It's layer mapping, the capital, like that. Then from .models, we're going to import the hospital model. Actually, this is supposed to be capital L, so it's capital L, capital M for layer mapping. Then let's create a hospital mapping. So hospital underscore mapping is going to be, so what we're basically trying to do, we're trying to map the models in our field with the models or with the fields that we had seen in our fields we had seen in our data. So if we can just go back to this, so we're going to map basically these fields to the fields in our model so that we can bring over the data to our database. So in the hotel mapping, you can see we're going to map the name field in our model to hospital in our data, like that. Then the next, what you're going to do next, you're going to map LON in our model. We're going to map it to LON long in our data. In our data it's presented as long, but in our hospital model it is LON. So we'll do the same for the latitude, fields, beds and the rest. So back here we can see lat is going to be mapped to capital lat, like that. Then FID is going to be mapped to FID. Yeah, let's just confirm. Yes, FID in caps. Good. Then we're going to map beds to beds, like that. Then we're going to map province name. Province underscore name. That's the way we had named it in our models. Yes, province underscore name. So we're going to map this to this admin en. Copy that. Come back to your load.py file. Map that to that. Then we're going to map the province code. And you're going to map that to it is admin 1 p code, like that. Perfect. So then the last field we're going to map is the geometry field. So we had said in our model it's going to be called geom, and our data field, as you can see, as you saw before, it's point. Our geometry is point, so geometry field is point in caps. Then we're going to load our shapefile. So you can say create a variable, call this hospital underscore shapefile. This is going to be derived, so we're going to create a path to our data. So in the hospital's app data, and we're going to create a path to this hospitals.shp file here. So let's just come back to load and say okay, it's path underscore underscore. We're creating a relative path, not a hard-coded path. We're going to resolve the parent. Then, just a minute, let me put that in. It's resolving from the parent, space slash, we go to the data folder, space, forward slash, and space. Then we're looking for hospital.shp. That's the relative path. Then we're going to have a function of run. So the run command, run method, let's say verbose is true. So within the run function, you can say layer mapping is going to, we're going to call the layer mapping. Remember, we had imported layer mapping there. So we're going to use layer mapping and pass in the hospital model. And then we're going to cast the hospital shapefile to string. So you can say string of the hospital shapefile. Then we're also going to call, add in the mapping. We'd call it hospital mapping. And you're going to say transform is false. So you're basically saying transform is false because the data doesn't need to be converted. It's already in WGS 84 with a spatial reference system identity of 4326. Then we say lm.save. We can save this to our database. And we're going to say strict is true. And verbose is equals to verbose, like that. So with our layer mapping done, it's time to invoke the GeoDjango shell. So you can go back to your terminal. So remember, we had created a make task for this. So in your make file, remember, fire up the shell, just say make shell. So back in our terminal, you can just say make shell. Then once our shell is ready, we're going to say from the hospitals app, we're going to import load. Now from the load file, we're going to run this method, the run. So just say load.run like that. Nice. So as you can see, we're getting an error. So could not open the data source hospitals.shapefile because it is hospitals.shapefile. So let's go back here and say from in our relative path, this was supposed to be hospitals.shp. So save this, then quit your shell first so that the changes are loaded. Then clear your terminal, then say make shell like that. Then now we can say from hospitals import load. Then you can say, let's try again, load.run. Perfect. As you can see, all this is saved in our database. Then let's quit this. Let's quit our shell. Then next we are going to import the admin boundaries. So for the admin boundaries, you're going to use a slightly different method so that you see the two different ways of creating a layer mapping. First, we're going to do the same thing. Let's inspect the boundaries shapefile. So back to your terminal, control L, let's say OGR info dash SO on the boundaries. Boundaries application for the data, then for the boundary.shp. Then let's have this layer called boundary. Perfect. As you can see, yes, now this geometry here, this time it's a polygon. There are five. The coordinate reference system is here. Then the fields that are contained here is admin en, p code, admin one, p code, that those are the fields. We have seen how to define geographic models and import data with the layer mapping data import utility. But you can automate this process with the use of OGR inspect management command. The OGR inspect command inspects a GDAL supported vector source, e.g. a shapefile, and generates a model definition and layer mapping dictionary automatically. Since we didn't create a make task for this, you can just type it out. You can say docker compose execute on the API service executing Python 3 manage.py OGR inspect. So we're going to inspect from the boundaries application data, inspecting the boundary.shapefile, and then let's give this layer a name, call it boundary, like that. Then the spatial SRID is going to be 4326, like that. Then I'm going to pass in a mapping, another flag, mapping. Then the other flag is multi. So basically the dash SRID option sets the SRID for the geographic field. Then the mapping option tells OGR inspect to also generate a mapping dictionary for use with layer mapping. Then the multi option is specified so that the geographic field is a multi-polygon field instead of just a polygon field. So if you run this, give it a while, as you can see, whatever we did manually while we're importing our hospitals field, here we are automatically generated. The model is automatically generated for us, and also the layer mapping, so we don't have to do things manually like we did before. So, but we still have to go back to our boundaries application, boundaries app, create a new file. Let's call this, it's going to be load.py, like that. Then we have some imports, so we can say from pathlib import path, import path, like that. Then from django.contrib.gis.utils, jsutils, you're going to import layer mapping, the capital, remember. Then from dot models, we're going to import the boundary model. So this time just copy our auto-generated boundary mapping, don't have to type everything out, paste it there. Then I'll just want to change, you can change a few fields. So in our database, I don't want to have this field, let's have a proper name. This is the boundary name. Then for the province code, let's just get rid of that, you just call it P code. Then for the geometry, it's a multi-polygon, but here in our model, I'll just call this M poly, like that, to symbolize multi-polygon. Then we're going to create our relative import path, so you can say boundary. Actually, let's just copy this from hospitals. So this shapefile, this shapefile and the run function, come back to boundaries, paste this. But now this is going to be, let's just copy that. All this is going to be boundary. Then we're going to resolve yes data, but this is now going to be called, we're looking for the boundary dot shapefile. Then the model here is going to be boundary, and then the mapping is going to be boundary mapping, and save that. In the boundaries app, in the models.py, we're going to create our boundary model. So we can say from django.contrib.gs.db import models, then from django.utils.translation, we're going to import get text lazy as an underscore. So for our boundary model, this time just come back here and copy our auto-generated model, like that, copy that, come back here, paste it. But then remember, for this one, in our layer mapping, we had said you're going to call this is going to be just a name, and let's add our translatable text string. So this is going to be province name. Then for the pcode, we had said this is just going to be pcode, so just confirm here, we had said it's going to be name pcode. So this is going to be pcode. Wow. We're going to call this province code. Province code, like that. With the maximum length of, this is just province code. It's just going to be one. Then, so remember our geometry field here, we said it's going to be M poly. So come back here and say this is going to be M poly, to symbolize a multi-polygon field. Then SRID is 4326. Then we're going to have a meta class. So class meta. So for verbose, plural. In the admin, the plural of our model field should just be boundaries, like that. Because if you don't specify this, Django will automatically pluralize this model and call it boundaries, like this. But I want the correct spelling, boundaries, like that. Then let's define the string representation of our model. So define string we're going to return self.name. Then we can make our migrations. So come back to your terminal, clear your terminal, say make migrations, then make migrate. So afterwards we're going to invoke the Django shell, you can say make shell like that, because we want to load our boundaries. So we can say from the boundaries up import load, then load dot run as we did before. As you can see, everything is saved to our database. Good. So we can quit out of this shell. So basically our loader has run and the data is saved to the database. So I think this is a good time to make a commit. So come back to your IDE, in our Git client. Let's say this is a feature, add layer mapping. Comma import data to DB. Perfect. Then if you so wish, let's just push this to GitHub. Thanks for watching. See you in the next section.